After Shithole Gate, the alt-right sadly loves Trump more than ever. For much of the sentient world, Donald Trump's deranged and appalling reference to Haiti, El Salvador, and African countries as shithole nations during a White House meeting on immigration reform, last Thursday, became the latest evidence of, among other things, the president's mental instability, the possibly irreparable descent of our democracy into an abysmal cesspool, and the chilling extent to which we have reversed decades of racial progress, the last of which was especially notable given the proximity of their remarks to Martin Luther King Jr. Day. The horrendous statement would drive the news cycle for 4 days, somehow proving that things could get worse for Trump than his depiction in Michael Wolff&apos ; Fire and Fury. Even the president appeared to understand, on some level, that he had spoken with woeful ignorance. By Sunday, Senators Tom Cotton and David Perdue, both Trump loyalists, said that they couldn't quite recall the word being used in the meeting, and attempted to publicly walk back the remark by proxy. As the weekend drew to a close, likely sensing the need to open a new front on their war with the media, the White House accused the Wall Street Journal of misquoting the president regarding his amorous relationship with erratic warmonger Kim Jong-un. On the far right, however, the president's use of the word shithole was largely celebrated as Trumpism in its purest, most puerile form. Donald Trump's first instinct that shithole would play well with his base was spot on, Kurt Bardella, a longtime Republican press relations professional and the former spokesman for Breitbart News, told me. No issue throughout the past 2 decades has had a more energizing and mobilizing effect on the conservative base and media than immigration. Indeed, the digital redoubts of the far right were buzzing with excitement to see all their favorite adversaries, Democrats, celebrities, CNN anchors, so apoplectic. Responses ranged from the far-fetched and bizarre, like Fox News host Jesse Waters, who noted, "This is how the forgotten men and women in America talk at the bar," to much, much worse. Some, such as one InfoWars editor, rejoiced that Trump had validated their beliefs that such countries were dumps. "Trump is more or less on the same page as us with regards to race and immigration," an editor at the neo-Nazi Daily Stormer wrote, calling Trump's comments encouraging and refreshing. Gateway Pundit, an ostensible news site more prone to spouting conspiracy theories, gleefully shared images and video of starving Venezuelans in an apparent, and ghastly, effort to prove the president correct. The president, notably, did not mention Venezuela in his crude remarks. On MLK Day, the site offered an even more outrageous argument. Martin Luther King Jr. would have stood with Trump, he didn't want migrants from the Third World here either. Breitbart, meanwhile, gleefully published stories about outraged, reliably liberal Hollywood celebrities, singling out Sean Penn at one point, as well as a host of triggered journalists from the shithole of fake news. InfoWars decided to take a cultural angle, writing up unaffiliated news stories and inserting shithole in the head for no intelligible reason. State Department warns, avoid travel to shithole countries. They all seem to share a similar strategy. Given the inarguable ghastliness of Trump's comments, the far right focused less on the indefensible statement itself than how seriously the left and media were taking the incident, a collective behavior that they attempted to portray as sanctimonious umbrage. What they're doing is focusing on the idea that, well, is it true to say that X impoverished country is a shithole? Said Will Summer, a media reporter for the Washington Examiner and the author of the Right Richter newsletter. The public hand-wringing over whether to print the word shithole merely fueled the right's apparent glee. "I can tell you this is all faux rage. It is made up," Rush Limbaugh seethed to his listeners, in a segment that was temporarily pushed on Breitbart's front page. "It is for the cameras. It's for the microphones. It's for the audience. CNN, reliably, got the worst of it. CNN has been possessed by asshole gate," the Daily Caller marveled at one point, eventually posting a supercut video of all the times that CNN anchors said shithole on live television. And as several GOP senators came forward to insist the president had not made those statements, and the White House itself sought to play them down, Trump's most ardent supporters happily saw an opening. Shithole comments were fake fucking news yet again. A reader on Reddit's Donald Trump subreddit screamed. Never trust a Democrat that indopos/s talking about Trump. Trump's base has always been a strange amalgamation of people who would normally never associate with each other, liberal-leaning populist nationalists and evangelical, anti-gay alleged pedophiles, pro-Israeli businessmen and neo-Nazi Holocaust deniers, Republican war hawks and ardent isolationists. They remain united largely by disgust toward various liberal totems, and the fact that the vast and balkanized right-wing digital universe allows them to vaguely agree without ever meeting. The left suffers its own version of this affliction, too, but it lacks a central disputant around which to colonize and often a near constant defense when the other side attacks. To the extent that our politics has become just one sick game of issuing blame, owning media cycles, and valuing the battles more than the outcome, Trump offers his amorphous base some cover. No one can quite say with certainty what he thinks or means at any moment. It's one of those Trump remarks where people will say, oh, he has a point, or oh, he's just doing something in a way that you can make liberals look hypocritical and out of touch, said Summer. It's like, look at these coastal elites freaking out. And even if he will never admit it in person, Trump may be aware of this. Shortly after the media erupted over his comments, he reportedly called all of his outside friends and allies, eager to see how the comments were playing out publicly. Fittingly, CNN reported, a White House official described it as a victory lap. Follow to get the latest news and analysis about the players in your inbox.